Designers Original. Designers Original. You know, there are some times that I have been privileged or I've stumbled on the TV programs that you will see the red carpet glamorous TV shows and event, and you see celebrities on red carpet and you see one or two reporters that will be asking them questions, you know, trying to tell them, they will be asking them, who are you wearing? The first time I heard that one, I said, which one, this kind of English is this one, who are you wearing? When does clothes and shoes become persons that they are saying who? I said, it should be what are you wearing? But it's not comfortable that that's what that maybe, maybe they are trying to say, who designed the clothes or the garment that you are wearing? So, and many of them, they will be mentioning names. And those clothes, some of them, they happen to be original, specifically designed for them, to suit them, to suit their size. Although some of those clothes, personally, I put them under different categories, the good, the bad, the ugly, and the demonic. Praise the Lord. But what we are talking about is designer's original. You are an original of God. Yes, in the book of Joshua chapter 1, verse 5, where we are going to be taking our text from, even though sometimes you may not see the correlation. God was telling Joshua there, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so will I be with thee. I will not what? Fail thee, nor forsake thee. Many times people make mistakes in this life by having people that they love, that are their mentors, that have inspired them, that have blessed them, trying to tailor their lives after them. Wrong. Very, very wrong. It's okay for anybody to challenge you, but it's not okay for you to copy or to want to be just like somebody, because God has not made replica of the same mold. That is why when you look at the fingerprints, no two persons will be carrying the same fingerprints. What is God saying? You are an original. In the book of Psalm 139, verse 14. Psalm 139, verse 14. Bible said that you have been fearfully and what? Wonderfully made. Meaning that God has made you specifically. God told Joshua, and I was with Moses, I will be with you. That's the mistake. People don't read that part very well. He doesn't say that. I want you to be just like Moses. Moses was a shepherd guy. He was a warrior. Moses was carrying the shepherd rod. And when he got to the place of parting water body, God ministered to Moses, stretch forth your rod. In the book of Exodus chapter 14, 21 and 22. And he stretched forth the rod, and the water parted. And the people walked on dry ground. And Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. And the Lord caused the sea, the Lord, that means he had been with him. The Lord caused the sea to go back by a strong east wind all that night and made the sea dry land. And the waters were divided. And the children of Israel went into the midst of the sea upon the dry ground. And the waters were a wall unto them on their right hand and on their left hand. He just had a rod, and God told him, just stretch for the rod. What of Joshua? He now got another water body. I raised my rod, he had no rod. That means that he will be stuck, trying to copy, or trying to go and get the rod, because I remember what Moses did. He would just, maybe he had done like this, the water did not pass. He would slap the water, part, the thing did not pass. Because God did not say that, just be like him exactly. He said that I will be with you. It's the presence of God that God has assured us not to copy people exactly. God loves varieties. I want to prove that in whatever way that you manifest, I am still there. I can still be with you. And when you go to the time of Joshua, in the book of Joshua chapter 3, Joshua chapter 3 verse 7, he told him, he said, don't worry, I'll start magnifying you from today so that these people will start respecting you. I will not do the way I did for Moses, but I will still do the things that Moses did and they will respect you. Still, don't try to want to copy exactly when I'm not moving you in that direction. And the Lord said unto Joshua, this day will I begin to magnify thee in the sight of the all Israel, that they may know that I was with Moses, so I will be. You can see this. What God kept telling him was, just ensure that my presence is with you. Not do it like Pastor Adeboye does, Pastor Adeboye does, Joyce Meyer. No! Be yourself, you are original. The way you do your ministration, I will see impact life through it. When you try to want to copy, it's okay to be inspired, to be challenged by them, but don't create a mold out of them to fit into it. It's wrong. You are limiting yourself. And in that Joshua chapter 3, 14 to 16, it got to the time that they had to cross water too. And God manifests in another way, and the water still parted. And people say, ah, so not only Jesus' rod that can part water, it's another thing, but not just another thing, it's God's presence that was with him, that was moving him in another direction. And it came to pass when the people removed from their tents to pass over Jordan, and the priest bearing the ark of the covenant before the people. Continue. And as they that bear the ark were come unto Jordan, and the feet of the priests that bear the ark were deep in the brim of the water, for Jordan overflowed all his bank, all the time of harvest, that the water which came from down from above stood and rose up upon an heap very far from the city Adam, that is beside Zarethan. And those that came down toward the sea of the plain, even the salt sea, failed and were cut off. And the people did what? Pass right against Jericho. Continue. Don't break this thing. And the priest that bear the ark of the covenant of the Lord stood firm on dry ground in the midst of Jordan. And all Israelites, not like the time of David, Moses too, pass over on what? Dry ground. Until all the people were passed clean over Jordan. You are a designer's original. Even though Moses has been a great man in his own time, it's okay. The message will be the same, but the method will be different. But I am still in the old situation. There are some people that teach people, you must be like me, you must do the way I am doing, or else you are not called. No! God, there was a particular person that ministered one time, and the person came to me. I said, Pastor, how was the ministration? I said, wow, that was, you did very well, excellently well. And I was praying for the person. And the person was about to do it, the person said, Pastor, are you just psyching me or you mean it? I said that you did excellently well. And truly, I meant it. You minister is not the way I minister, but I respect the mood that God has made him that way. Every leader ought to start understanding that and not just be pleased in people wanting to create you as the mold. Release them. Whether you're a fashion designer, just be impacted by the grace and go and minister and function excellently. I may not be called towards orphanage, but if God already, but you can get ministered to and see clearer vision in that particular area of your calling and go and shine there. That is what God expects of us. I was trained in a parish that I've always had one service on Sunday, you know, today. But by the time I was called out to start as a pastor, because God had given me the mentality that I respect my mentors, I respect my leader, but I am not them. God has created me. I have been wonderfully and kept. That means that I have to seek God to know what God wants me to do. It's just His presence that I need. It is His presence. And He told me, start with two services. I've never seen that done anywhere before. I know that somebody can start with one service, over time they will become two services. Then I start with two services when we are just less than 20, and they pray that the capacity of 200, how will it be? It does not make sense. But I did not conform to what I have been trained in. Said that as I was with Moses, so will I be with you. Abraham was into animal husbandry. In the book of Genesis chapter 13, verse 2, animal husbandry. The Bible said that he had a lot of cattle. He was into animal. Animal really. And he prospered. By the time he was dying, in Genesis 25, 1, he gave all that he had to Isaac. That's what some parents do. I'm a doctor. Every child must be a doctor. No. Discover who God has made them to be and release them into their calling. That's why some people, they will study something. It's another thing that they will be manifesting. Right above that you will not be conforming your children to what you think that you are not their God. You are just their caretaker. And God said that Abraham gave all he had to Isaac, but he lost everything in famine. In Genesis chapter 21, 26 verse 1, everything was lost. Because God had not designed this guy to be into animal husbandry. He was into planting. Later he now discovered in Genesis 26, 12 and 13. Genesis 26, 12 and 13. And God said that, and Isaac sold in that land. I immediately sold. He didn't think just started manifesting. In that same year, he reaped 100-fold. Don't let people create a mold for you. There are some things that I like. You can give me options of life, but leave me to choose what suits me. You can give me options in life or what, but leave me to see, to choose and know what suits me and let me fulfill my destiny. I am rising above the expectation of people every day. You might work with God. I don't care whatever they say, whatever. I will be myself as long as what I'm doing is not under sin. Categorized under sin. His option is just about the way and manner I'm doing it, but it doesn't sin. As long as it is bringing results, fine. Don't let. The Bible said that those that compare themselves with themselves, they are not why in the book of 1 Corinthians, I think it should be 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 12. 1 Corinthians 10, 12. The Bible said that they that have compared themselves with themselves, they are not wise. He said, as I was with Moses, so will I be with you. You are an original of God. Don't let anybody. The onus is on everybody to not discover who you are. That is the onus. Discover the area of gifting. Discover what God, and don't let anybody chip in whatever you are doing. The fact that you are not making, you are not carrying microphone, does not mean that God is not marking you higher than somebody that is carrying microphone. Last year we gave awards in this place to people that we thought that they did very well. Among them happened to be one brother. He had never had microphone to preach yet. But in the sporting world, he influenced sportsmen and sport women once in a while to come to the church and will say, Pastor, can you come and preach to these people? Because he's in that profession. I will minister to them. Many of them will give their life to Christ. And many of them are still connected to us today. Many of them, you see them coming to church just because of somebody. That could be his own ministry, and it's fine, and I respect that. Because that I may not be able to do in that particular area of his calling. Nobody should conform you. There was another woman that we gave our own. She always sends something to us every month for our TLC. She's not a member of this church. But for the past 6 years, Pastor Tok, for over many years, I never saw her. But you just call on the phone. But every month, a bag of rice, vegetable, after I buy, she started using monetizing. He said, I know that you people do this every Sunday. I want to be a blessing to this church because I believe that God is working in this church and has been doing that. I will give her a word. He said that as I was with Moses, he did not say that be like Moses. That was not the instruction. As I was with Moses, so will I be with you. Just be yourself. Moses never carried sword, but you are a fighter. Moses will be using his mouth to tell Pharaoh some things, and I'll be doing it. You don't just use your mouth, use your sword, because you have many land to possess. The word has come to somebody here. Don't be depressed unnecessarily because you are not able to measure up to somebody's standard at that time. That's why I was telling that brother, I will not do what he did, I mean do it in another, but I'm able to respect what he did at that level that he was doing it as excellent for that level. Don't let people put you down. Be encouraged. Let's rise to our feet. I want to open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me to discover who you have made me to be. And let me walk in it. In the name of Jesus, let me walk in it. Regardless of what somebody is doing, let me walk in it. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Today, we are only 4 services, but let me tell you something. There are some people that are having a single service. It does not mean we are better than them. If that is what God has called them to be doing, they are 100% okay. So nobody should be, in the book of John chapter 21 and 22, John 21, 21 and 22, Peter was talking about John the Beloved. When Jesus Christ was giving instruction, feed my fish, feed my lamb. He said, what of this one? What will he do? Jesus Christ said, what is your business? Face your business. Peter seeing him, said to Jesus, Lord, and what shall this man do? Jesus said unto him, if I will that he carry till I come, what is that to thee? What did he say? Follow that means that mind your business. That is what everybody is supposed to do. Hey, to tell your neighbor, mind your business.
Mind your business.
Don't look at me that you cannot preach. You cannot. That person may not be called in that direction. That person may be called in the direction of catering, in the direction of fashion, in the direction of management. Whatever the person has been called, just stay there and shine for God. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me to discover who I am. Manifest your glory there in the name of Jesus. Help me to discover who I am and manifest your glory there. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Even some people up to dressing. I'm sure it's okay to do. Some people will be dressing like. There are some things. I respect men of God. But I don't like, there's something that me I don't, you sure you understand?
Yes.
There's a way me I like to dress. But I still respect the man. I'm not into this fresh something. But my father in the Lord loves that. God bless him for that. I want some, you know, correct, some things that look somehow, you know. That is me. And somebody else may not like that. It's okay. Just let God be glorified. And people will love that person that God has called. Whoever God has called with you, they will just blend with you. No problem. But that people that will say, what is the big deal? It's just because God has not called them. But they will not understand. You will not understand that God has not called this person with this person. That's why you will not understand or appreciate him. Finally say, Father, I glorify you. Because you are wonderfully and perfectly made. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Father, we thank you for today's ministration like instruction. Help us to act to the instruction so that we fulfill our destiny. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Thank you.